Dona Olinda struggles to find the words about what it was like back then when the Ford Motor Company from the United States descended on her little village in the Amazon. It was in the 1920s. Henry Ford was in need of rubber for tires for vehicles for his fast-growing car company. So he bought a 10,000 square kilometer piece of Amazon where rubber trees were native. Ford planted a flag on his land and named it Fordlandia. The company aggressively cleared the land and built a new city with fancy American-style houses and schools, and a hospital with the latest technology. And it was all available to everyone, even if you weren't one of the 4,000 locals hired by the Ford company.
Foi o primeiro grande investimento, né?
What he built in the middle of the jungle was a remarkable accomplishment, like nothing ever seen before at that time in the history for this region. It looked promising at first, but Ford's American managers weren't botanists, and most of the trees died when they improperly tried to recultivate the land. Synthetic rubber was then invented back in the US, ending any demand for Amazon rubber.
In this plant alone, Ford was expecting to produce enough rubber for the tires for 2 million cars a year. But he never even got close to reaching that goal. So in 1945, he simply walked away from it all and sold the entire city of Fordlandia back to the Brazilian government for a mere $250,000.
And as quickly as he created Fordlandia, Henry Ford abandoned it. The Americans went back to company headquarters in Dearborn, Michigan, and so did any hope for the locals. Fordlandia, population 2,000, still exists today. But the Ford buildings have been left rotting, mostly deserted. A few tattered signs of Americana are left hanging around. But the Brazilian government never put the buildings to use. It was simply too remote an area to serve any purpose. To some, Ford didn't mean any harm, and point to the fact that the company paid off any debt to local workers before leaving. Others point to the environmental destruction caused by Fordlandia and the abandoned buildings as the 20th century's first example of the cold reality of corporate capitalism. A failure. That is the only way to ultultimately describe how Fordlandia ended up for Henry Ford. Dona Olinda is 98 years old now. She's one of only a couple Brazilians still alive who worked for Ford. Her memory is faded from that time, and maybe that's a good thing, considering how the last chapter of Henry Ford's Amazon misadventure turned out. Gabriel Elizondo, Al Jazeera, Fordlandia, Brazil.